In today's lecture, we will learn about calculated columns in Power BI. Here I can show you a very small data model. In this model, we have one student sheet that contains student ID and student name. We have five students, and you can see the five name here. And the other sheet is marks. It contains student ID, a marks ID, student subjects, midterm, final terms, marks. And we have to calculate the percentage of each subject wise and on student level. So let's do how we can perform this thing in Power BI. So I have imported this data model into the Power BI. So here we can go to the Power BI, and I have already imported this data into the Power BI. Here you can see we have one table student and the other table is marks. And these two tables are interconnected with each other using student ID, because the student ID is common in both tables. Let's go to the data tab, and in this data tab you can see every student has five subjects, like physics, chemistry, math, computer and bio. So these subjects are repeated each time. So we have five students and 25 subjects, and every subject has one midterm marks and the other is the final term marks. And we have to add one more calculated column that combine both marks, midterm marks plus final term marks. So let's do how we can perform this in Power BI. For this, we have to go click to the modeling tab, and then there is one tab here, new columns. Here we can write obtain marks, and then we have to take this column, midterm marks. Midterm marks plus final term marks, and hit enter. And here we can see every subject, like physics marks, you can see midterm marks 15 plus 50 is 65, 20 plus 55, this is 75. So we got a new column, new calculated column, that based on this formula and contain these values. So let's add one more column. We need another column so that we should know that what are the total marks for each subject. So we can generate one more column. Just click here, and here we can write total marks. And total marks for each subject is 100. Just write simply 100. And here we can see a column that contain the total marks for every subject. So now we need a percentage. One more column that contain the percentage. So we have to click here, new column, and we can add percentage. Or we can write marks percentage, and we can divide obtained marks divided by total marks. So here we can see we got percentage marks for every subject, 65, and it is 0.65, 0.75, and we can format this column so that we should get the proper percentage for format here. You just need to click under modeling, you just need to click this sign. So because the data type of this column is decimal and the format is general, and you just need to click format percentage. And here we can also change to decimal points up to 1 or 0, it's up to you. So here you can see 65.0%, 75.0%. Okay. So let's go to so here you can see we created three columns: obtained marks, total marks, and percentage of each marks each subject. So we can go to the report level. We can click on student. Here you can see student name. So here you can see different subjects, and then we can add marks percentage. So here you can see percentage marks is fine subject wise. But what happens if we need to see this percentage on student level? If I just delete subject. And here you can see this percentage is not fine. How we are getting this value? This value is because Dux by default summing up this marks percentage. So how we know that? Just go here and under percentage you can just click, and you can see the underlying calculation is sum. That's why it is calculating all these values, these all percentages. For example, if I go here on the data tab, here you can see in the student one, we have these percentages: 65, 75, 87, and 64, and 65. So after calculating, after summing up these values, it is generating this result, 356, because calculated column compute values row by row. So by row by row it is fine, but once we are trying to calculate on a report level, we are getting issue because calculated column cannot compute values on a report cell level. So this is cell, this is cell 1, cell 2, and it cannot perform this stuff here. Let's add some more columns. Let me select, and we can add obtained marks, and I can add total marks. See, so what should be the exact result? It should calculate, for example, if I calculator, and it should work like this: 356 divided by 500. So it should calculate these values like 71% for the first student. But as I said, calculate columns calculate values row by row. So it works fine row by row, but it will not work on a report level. So how we can solve this problem? We will try to fix this issue by using Power BI measures. So let's meet to the next lecture, and then we will continue this problem by using measures, that how measures solve this issue.